Kaya nga eh, sana all nagkakape.
Si Nyanggar ma'am, ga-join right do?
Okay ah, be sure ah, take note. Be sure all of you already got or took your midterm exam. Kasi paka, kasi nagbigay kanina lang yung aking, yung ating assessors for the written exam, I mean the midterm exam. So, nagbigay siya ng link. Kasi as one sila nagabigay ng results. So, hindi ko pa alam what is your results. So, sila pa yung magbibigay sa amin later on. Okay? So, regarding sa midterm. Anyway, so, we're done with our midterm, the first three. So, nandito na po tayo kay Module 4. So, si Module po ang starting ng ating class, ay starting ng ating topics for the final exam. So, your final exam is before your semestral break. So, we have here December 15, 16, and 17 is your final exam. So, after that, semestral break na po tayo. So, you're getting ready for your second sem on January. Your January po yung second sem natin. And then, during that time also, after your final exam is your Christmas break also. Christmas break na po yan. Ayan. So, ito po yung ating first topic sa ating module 4. So, on the Thursday, wala pong activities regarding the module 4, but you have your quiz number 3. Okay, yung quiz number 3 natin regarding sa ating module 3. Take note na, module 2, module 3 po ang ating quiz number 3 and it will be uploaded in your Google Classroom by Thursday 2:30. Okay. Yan. So, we will now tackle the module 4, which is statistics. So, there will be 3 topics under it. So, we have the measures of central tendency, the correlations, and the testing of hypotheses, and regression. So, we will only tackling first the measures of central tendency. So, ito lang muna ang ating itatackle. After that, ito na po si correlations and testing of hypotheses and regression. Okay, so what is measures of central tendency? Later on, ibibigay ko pala itong video about mode, median, mean, range, and standard deviation. So, ibibigay ko lang later on. Ayan. Okay, so before we will discuss on the measures of central tendency, we have the definition of terms. We have the statistics, descriptive statistics, and the inferential statistics. So statistics po, it is involves the collection, organization, summarization, presentation, and interpretation of data. While si descriptive is a branch of statistics, that involves, same pa rin, no? Collection, organization, summarization, and presentation of data. Yan lang po siya. Wala po siyang interpretation because the interpretations will be on the inferential. Siya yung mag-i-interpret or mag-draw ng conclusion kung may, meron bang, tawag dyan, meron ba silang correlations or may relasyon ba yung isang data, mga ganyan. Unlike yung si descriptive, i-describe mo lang siya. Kaya nga sinabing descriptive. Because you're just going to collect, and then i-organize mo lang yung data mo, and then summarize, and then present. So you're just going to describe on what data do you have on hand. Yun. Okay, so we will start with the arithmetic mean. So actually, no, in this module 4, it focuses on statistics. Statistics pala, I mean, rather, statistics is used when you're doing a research. Pag meron po kayong research, kailangan nyo po si statistics kasi yun po yung ginagamit in handling the data that you conduct a survey in your research. Yan. So, first is the arithmetic mean. So, kay measures of central tendency pa naman tayo, so, we're just focusing on the arithmetic mean. So, ano po si arithmetic mean? It often helpful to find numerical values that locate, in some sense, the center of a set of data. It is most commonly used in measuring the central tendency. It often referred to as simply the mean. So, pwede pong sa arithmetic mean or the mean. So, ito yung kanyang, yan po yung kanyang formula rather. So, ito yung formula, no? The summation of x divided by n. Pag sinabi natin summation, it means that you're going to get the sum of all the data and then you divide that to the n. Yung n po is the number of data do you have. Yun. For example, we have an example here. 6 friends in biology class of 20 students received test grade of 92, 84, 65, 76, 88, and 90. Then find the mean of these test scores. Okay. So, we only have, take note ha, hindi po natin i-add ito, and then you divide sa 20. These test grades is for 6 friends only. So, therefore, divide natin kay 6 lang. I-add natin si 92, 84, 65, 76, 88, and 90. Then, this is the sum, divide it to 6, and this is the mean. Yan po, ganyan po yung pagkuha kay mean. You get the sum, divide it to the total number of populations or samples, then yun po yung kanyang mean. Okay. So, what is population and sample? Kasi mostly sa statistics, we are talking about populations and samples. So, anong difference nila? Population is the entire group under consideration. So, we are using pag population, pag lahat ng group, we are using the U. While the sample is any subset of the population. And ito lang po yung gagamitin natin. That is why, yung sa example natin, ito yung ginamit because sample lang siya sa 20 students. 6 friends lang out of 20. So, ito yung ginamit. Pero pag lahat 20 students, yan po yung gagamitin natin as a symbol for our getting the mean. Ayan. Okay, for example, first year BSMRE yung ating population. Then yung 1 Charlie is just a sample of the population of the first year BSSMRE. Yun po yung ibig sabihin doon. Okay? So, we're done with the mean. So, yun mean ha, you just add, then divide kung ilang yung samples mo. Ganyan yung mean. Ngayon kay median. What is the median? Median, kaya nga middle. It's the middle number or the mean of the 2 middle numbers. So, middle number, pag add number, I mean add yung data nyo, kunin mo yung middle. Pero pag hindi siya add, even siya, so, kukunin mo yung mean ng dalawang middle numbers. So, this is how you get the median. First, in getting the median, wait lang. Okay, in getting the median, you need to rank. Unlike yung kanina, no? Going back po tayo sa example. Ayan. Unlike yung kanina, hindi ko siya ni-rank. Kasi kukuha naman ako ng sum. So there's no need to rank in the median. I mean, in the mean. But if you're getting the median, you need to get a rank. I mean, you need to rank them using the rank list. So, how is that? Rank list is any list of numbers that is arranged in a numerical order from smallest to largest. Take note, ha? You can rank them from smallest to largest or largest to smallest. So, ano yung median? You need to get the middle number if n is odd. The mean of two middle numbers if n is even. For example, find the median of the data in the following list. So we have 4, 8, 1, 14, 9, 21, and 12. So what will be the median? First is you're going to rank them. Ayan. Narank, no? Nirank na. Eh, sorry. So nirank yung letter A. So narank na. So from smallest to highest, ito na yon. And we have here from smallest to highest. First, count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So since it's 7, so yung middle is on the 4. So we have here the 4, kaapat. So this will be your median. Dito naman sa kabila, count natin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So sa is, a 6. So it is even. So ang gitna niya ay dalawa. So we have here, cancel dito, cancel yan. So ito yung gitna, yung dalawa. So in getting this, you just add the 77 plus 89 and then divided by 2. Yung answers will be the median. For example, I will use the calculator first. 77 plus the 89, that is 166. Divide by 2, then this give us 83. So that will be your median for this data. Ayan. Ayan po yung middle number. So the middle number is 9, hence 9 is the median. Ayan po yung middle number. So 77 plus 89 divide by 2 gives us 83. Therefore, 83 is the median. So that is how you're getting the median. Now we go to the mode. So we're done with the mean. Mean is getting the sum, then divided by ilan sila lahat. The median, getting the middle. Ano naman si mode? Si mode po is the number that occurs most frequently in a list of numbers. Ano yung numbers na palaging lumalabas? Yan. So, meron, may mode, meron din more than one mode. Pag no mode, ibig sabihin, no number occurs more than often than the other numbers. More than one mode, the number occurs less than the other numbers. Yan. For example, we have here, find the mode of the data, this one and this one. So in the mode, same lang siya kay mean. Hindi na po siya kailangang i-arrange or i-rank from smallest to largest and largest to smallest. So kahit saan. Basta i-count nyo lang kung ilang beses siya lumabas. So we have here, si 14, isa lang. Si 15, 1, 2, 3, 15, tatlo, si 16, 1, si 18, 1, and si 21 is 2. So, ano yung pinakamalaki? Si 15. So, yan po yung kanyang mode. May 3 modes. Ngayon, meron din tayo dito. Kabila, we have 2 is 1, 4 is 1, 3, 5 is 1, 7 is 1, 8 is 1, 9 is 1, 11 is 1, 23 is 1. So, ibig sabihin, wala pong more than one na lumabas. Kasi si mode po, more than one na lumabas. Maraming beses siya lumabas. Or more than, I mean, two or more beses siya lumabas. Yun po yung mode. Since wala pong two or more, so for this data set, there are no modes. Okay? Ayan. So, in the letter A, so since 15 occurs 3, so siya yung pinakamalaki. So, siya po, si 15 po yung mode. Yun po yung ibig sabihin dyan. Kasi sino yung pinakamalaki, siya yung mode. Pero if ever, meron pang 21 dito. So 21 is tatlo na. So ibig sabihin, si 15 and 21 po ang mode. Kasi pareha silang higher na number 3 na nag-occur, and dalawa silang parehas. So 15 and 21 po ang mode. Pero pa yung letter B, there is no mode since wala po nag-occur more than once. Okay? Lahat sila ay nag-occur lang isang beses. So, wala pong mode. Kasi ang mode, more than once po nag-occur at yung pinakamalaking occurrences, yun po ang mode. Okay, so we have a note here. So, the mean, median, and the mode are all averages. However, they are generally not equal. So, hindi po sila equal. The mean is the most sensitive of the averages. A change in any of the number changes the mean. Yes, of course. Kasi nagkakuha lang po tayo ng kumukuha lang po tayo ng data. I mean, kumukuha lang po tayo ng mean. Kasi ang mean, no, we're getting the sum, then divided by ilang beses. So, pag malalaki yung mga sum, ang mga values, nag-change siya, so mag-change din yung mean. Unlike sa median and mode, kahit mag-change siya, kasi kukunin mo naman is middle. Ito naman, kukunin mo ilang beses siya naglagay, lumabas. So, hindi po siya mag-change pag meron po tayong data na mag-add, I mean, mag-change yung value or whatsoever. So, yon. Meron din tayong tinawag na weighted mean. Ano si weighted mean? Weighted mean is often used when some data values are more important than others. It is like getting your average grade in your first year, where you consider the weighted units of each subject you take. For example, no, yung inyong subject. So yung NGEC 4 is 3 units. I don't know with math shop, no? Yung mga shop, I guess malalaki yan kasi may laboratory. Assuming is 5 units. Ayan. And then meron tayong AS. Yung AS nyo is 1 unit. So, pag meron kayong grade sa NGEC 4 na assuming 2 plat, yan. Sa mashup, we have 2.5. Sa AS, meron kang 1.5. Yan. In getting your mean or your average, hindi po i-add nyo yan. 2, so magiging 6 yan. Divided by 3, kasi tatlong subject. So yung grade mo for that, grade mo for first year is first year, first semester is 2 plat. No. You're going to use the weighted mean. Kasi, depende yan sa units. For example, dito no, kay NGEC 4, kailangan mo 2 times 3. So, your grade is 6. Tapos, sa mashup, 2.5 times 5. Yan po yung ibig sabihin ni weighted mean. You need to multiply the weighted value, 1. Tapos, dyan pa, i-add nyo yan, and then i-divide into 3. Then, yun po yung score ninyo. Ganyan po yung ibig sabihin ni weighted mean. Okay, so we have here, no? We have here the formula. So, weighted mean is the summation of x times the w, where w is the sum of the products formed by multiplying each number by its assigned weight. And summation of W is the sum of all weights. Ayan. For example, ayan. So, use the weighted mean formula to find Dillon's GPA or general point average for the fall of semester, wherein A is 4 points, B is 3 points, C is 2 points, and D is 1 point. And these are their units. Yun na yung kanina binigay ko, 5 units yung mashup, 3 units yung NGEC 4, yung AS formation nyo is 1 unit, so yan. And then, this B is 3, A is 4, B is 1, and C is 2. Ayan. And then, ang pagkuha niyan is, ito. So, get the summation of all the course units. So, 4 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4, we have 14. Ngayon, itong 14, yan po ilalagay natin sa baba. Ito, siyempre, 3 times 4, 4 times 3, 1 times 3, and 2 times 4. Ayan. And these are the product, and you add them, and we have 35 divided by 14, and we have their Dillon's GPA is 2.5. So, ganyan po yung pagkuha ng inyong grade for the first semester. Hindi po, i-add nyo lang lahat yung grade nyo divided by ilang subject. No. You need to get all of the units, the sum of all the units, yun po yung i-divide nyo, and then multiply your grade to each specific unit, then get their product, then the sum, then divide that to the total weight average of your first semester subject. So, ganun po yung pagkuha ng grades using your weighted mean. Weighted mean is only used in getting your grade. Okay? Ah, mali pa to. Hindi ko pa change. Okay, sorry. So, do you have any questions? May questions ba tayo?
None, ma'am.
Okay, none. So, let me continue. Actually, may bibigay akong activity, no? This one. So, I will give this activity in your Google Classroom kasama yung quiz nyo. So, this activity will be, the deadline is a week after, while the quiz deadline will be on that Thursday. So, you have 1.5 hour to do your quiz, quiz number 3. Okay, so we have the correlation. So, yung correlations, no? For this time, so hindi muna natin discuss si correlation. So, i-discuss ko si correlation by next Tuesday. Kasama si, tawag dyan. So, let me see, no? Okay, I guess I still have, I need to, so give me until, i-discuss ko na lang, no, kasi medyo mahaba pala pag i-discuss ko si correlation kasama kay hypothesis. So, i-discuss ko si yung kalahati ni correlation. Okay, still 3 o'clock pa naman. Okay, so correlation. So, ano si correlation? Ang correlation is measuring the association or the relationship. Wait. Hindi siya naka-pen. Measuring the association or the strength of your relationship between the two variables, say X and Y. So, meron tayong 10 items. So, ito yung... So, titingnan natin kung may correlation ba yung mathematics score ng isang estudyante sa kanyang English score. So, bale, dalawa po yung kanyang variables. You want to determine among the 10 students, what is the correlation or is there a relationship on their mathematics score to their English score? Ibig sabihin, kung mataas ba ako sa math, mataas din ba ako sa English? Or kung mataas ba ako sa math, mababa ba ako sa English? Or kung mababa ako sa math, mataas ako sa English? Parang ganyan. So that is the relationship. Meron bang meron ba tayong makikitang may relasyon ba silang dalawa? Yan. Yan po yung correlation. Okay, for example, in using that, nakikita no? So si X po yung mathematics score and si Y po yung English score. So nagplot siya. Yan. Yan po yung ito po yung mathematics, ito po yung English. Ayan. So, in the graph, it indicates that there is a direct correlation between the variables X and Y because it appears to be increasing. Bakit increasing? It will assume, gagawa ka ng line na ganito. As you can see, meron kayong mga dots and it's increasing. Then it shows that there is a direct correlations between math and English. Ayan. So, suppose the scores of the student in those two subjects happen to be as follows. Ayan. For example, yan na naman, no? Yung scores niya. Nakita natin, in plotting, nakita din natin na ganyan yung kanyang map. So, pag gumawa tayo, walang ganito. Pero pag ganito ang ating graph, it shows that it's decreasing. Okay? So, the variables are negatively correlated. Yun po yung ibig sabihin niya. Next. Suppose ito naman yung score ng ating estudyante. Ayan. If you're going to put like this, wala namang sumasama dun. Ito naman, meron tayong dito na malayo. So that's me, this means that it's neither increasing nor decreasing. So, walang relationship si mathematics student, mathematics score sa English score nila ng estudyante. Ayan. So, yun po ang correlation. So, we have three definitions for the correlations. So, it can be positively correlated. Yung kanina nakita natin, no? It's increasing. Negatively correlated, yung kanina nakita natin, is decreasing. And zero correlation, so hindi sila related, yung last. Ayan. So, ang ginamit dong kanina is scatter plot. Pag sa atin yun, it's graphing, no? Nag-graph po tayo. Actually, ang term ng graphing doon sa statistics is, ano yun aking, scatter plot. Scatter plot is a convenient way of inspecting correlation between two variables, but it does not offer a measure of the strength of a correlation. Nagpapakita lang ito ng kanyang graphs, pero wala siyang measure kung gaano katiba yung correlations nila. So, in getting the correlations, meron po tayong tawag na PPMC or the person product moment correlation. Tingnan natin yung isa, no? Wait ah. Yung isa naman si Spearman's rank order correlations. So for this time, si Spearman's i-discuss ko na lang yan sa next meeting. Okay? So sa kay person lang tayo. Okay. The first one to get the measure of the strength of your correlation is using the Pearson product moment correlation, which is symbolizes by R sub X sub Y, R sub X and Y. Okay? So this is a formula that can give a numerical value to the measure of correlation. It does not only show how greatly two data sets are correlated, but also reveals if the correlation is direct or inverse, or if the data sets are correlated. So we have here a degree of correlation. It can either be one, a strong positive correlation, or zero as no relationship, and negative one as the strong negative correlation. Ayan. Ito po yung kanyang formula. Yan. Yan po yung formula ni person product correlation. So paano natin gagamitin yan? Ayan, titingnan natin yan. So, ito yung ating variables, no? Pag yung answer natin is equals to 1, so perfect positive correlation. If your answer is, gawin na lang natin, no? Equals to 0.7 to 0.9. Strong positive correlation. And this one is 0.6 na lang. 0.1 to 0.5. Positive correlation yan. And for the strong negative correlations, we have is R is negative 1, negative 1. Yung negative correlation is R is negative 0.22, 0.1 to negative 0.7. Ayan. If your answer is R is equals to negative 0.8 to negative 1, strong negative correlation. And if your answer is 0.1 negative 0.1 to negative 0.7, negative correlation yan. Pag your R is equivalent to 0, then there is little or no correlation. So yun ang magiging basihan natin sa pagkuha ng inyong score. Here, ito yung ating table. So ganun po yung table natin, no? So paano natin i-compute yan? So we have here, ayan. Kailangan i-answer nyo yan dito. Ayan. So hindi ko pa yan ibibigay, no? By next week ko na yan ibibigay yung paano yung answers dyan. Okay, ito yung dapat na answers nyo. Yan po yung galing dun sa blank. Paano yan nakuha? X sub I minus the summation of X. This is your summation. Where is the summation? Actually, wala, no? Okay, summation, I mean, the mean of X is, this is the summation, 48 divide, ilan yan? 10. Kasi 10 yan, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ano yung aking paper? 4.8 yung ating mean of X. The mean of Y is 50 divided by 10, which is 5. Ayan. Ito yung kinuha, 50 divided by, ilan yan sila? Ilang estudyante? 10. Okay. Paano to nakuha? X sub I, this is your X sub I. 4 minus 4.8, it will give you negative 0.8. 4 minus 4.8. Tapos 5 minus 4.8. Ganyan lang, no, pagkuha. 9 minus 4.8. 2 minus 4.8. And so on. Saan nakuha yan? Dito. 4 minus 4.8. 5 minus the 4.8. 9 minus the 4.8. 2 minus the 4.8, 8 minus the 4.8. Yan po yung ibig sabihin dito. Same with this one. 5 minus the 5, 0. 5 minus the 5. Ano yung 5, ma'am? Yan po yung dito. Actually, dapat meron yan dito. The mean of the Y. 4 minus the 5. Ayan, 4. 8 minus the 5, 3 minus the 5, and so on. Ganyan po yung pag-compute. Okay, how about this one? Square mo lang. Negative 0.8 times negative 0.8. You just substitute the, ano nakikita natin dito? Yan. 0.2 times 0.2, 4.2 times 4.2, negative 2.8 times negative 2.8, and so on. Same with this one, 0 times 0, negative 1 times negative 1, 3 times 3, negative 2 times 2, dito po yan sa answers nyo. Summation, paano kunin? Just add them, ha? I-add nyo lang. And so with this one, just add them. Ayan. Ma'am, paano to dito? Paano kinuha yan dito? Ayan. Ito. Ano to? Ito yan dito. Then ito. Ano to? Ito yan dito. So, itong dito, imu-multiply dito times. So, we have negative 0.8 times 0. So, equals to 0. Ano pa? 0.2 times negative 1. So, negative 0.2. 4.2 times 3, 12.6. Negative 2.8 times negative 2, 5.6. And so on. Then, get the summation. Yan. So, ganyan po yung pag-fill up ng inyong data or table. After fill upping the table, then substitute the formula. Ito yung formula natin. Yan. Ito, may makita tayo doon sa table. And so with this one. And so with this one. Just substitute. Yung ito, this is the value, 58. And this one, this is the value, 65.6. And this one, this is a value, 60. Ayan. Ay, sorry. Ayan. Then, the product of 65.6 divided by 60 is 39.36. Get the square root. Yan yung answer. Then, 58 divided by here, we have 0.92. Anong ibig sabihin ng 0.92? The computed correlation is almost 1. Hence, it has a strong positive correlation. So, yun po yung ibig sabihin dyan. So, that is how you're going to use the PPMC. So, anong purpose ni person, product, moment, correlation, or PPMC? It is applicable when the two variables under study are interval type of data. Ibig sabihin ng interval type, by numbers lang siya. Okay? So, I guess that's it, no? Si Spearman, next meeting na yan, i-discuss ko. So, any questions regarding the median, mode, weighted mean, the mean, and the person-product-moment correlation? O, meron po ba tayong question? Any more questions? I guess, okay, none, no? Ay, sorry. Okay, I guess none. So, please open your camera for our documentation for today. Okay, open yung ating camera. Okay, 1, 2, 3, smile. Oh, teka, no? Another one. Wait lang. 1, 2, 3, smile. Okay, class, see you again on the Tuesday for our topic. But on Thursday, prepare for your quiz. You're going to have your quiz on Thursday regarding Module 3. Okay? So, yes, if no more questions.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, no more questions.
Yes, ma'am.
So, pass this way. See you on the Tuesday. Okay, bye-bye. Okay, bye-bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Okay, bye.
Bye-bye, ma'am.